What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. I've recently just done a video which shows you how to set up ESP Home on your NSPanel, but also how to set it up and use it with the NSPanel Home Assistant Blueprint. Essentially, what this project allows you to do is it allows you to set up and configure your NSPanel, all without having to write any code, or without having to use things like the Next-Gen editor. Now, you are just limited to the template that you provided within the blueprint, but for a lot of people, that's going to be more than plenty. You get access to 32 different buttons that you can set up and customize, and you can have them do whatever you want. In the tutorial video that I did, I don't feel like I showed off the features of this project enough, so that's what I'm going to do now. We're just going to quickly run through some of the features and things that you can do. Then if you are interested in checking this project out, you'll find a link to it in the description below, as well as a link to the video that I did, if it's now uploaded. From the top then, we've got the first page that you'll see, and this is known as the home page. The recurring theme throughout the project is that you're actually able to customize and modify all of the different entities and devices, as well as the text labels that you're actually able to see on the screen. So on the homepage, in the top right corner, we can see the current day and time. To the left of that, we've got the weather, and this is set in Home Assistant, so it knows what the weather is for the next few days. And if we select the weather, we can actually cycle through all of the current forecasts for the next 5 days. Just below the weather, we've got the indoor room temperature, as well as the indoor room humidity. And below those again, we've got two text labels for the physical hardware buttons. So on my ones here, you can see I've called it Office and R2. Below those text labels are two lines, and these lines indicate whether the physical relay is on or off. So if they're on, they're blue, and if they're off, they're just this kind of grey colour. In the very bottom left corner there, there's a very small cog icon. And if you select that, that'll take you into the kind of settings page, and this page will allow you to reboot the device. It will allow you to toggle off the sleep mode, so if you want the device's screen to turn off after a set period of time. You can also adjust the brightness as well as the dimming, and the dimming is going to be the level that it actually dims down to after there's been no interaction on the screen. Swiping left on the home page will take you to your first page of your four customizable pages. Alternatively, you can actually swipe up, down, left or right to quickly jump to one of these pages without having to just swipe left through them all. The gesture feature is a really nice addition because after a while of using the panel, you'll build up a bit of muscle memory and you'll know which gesture equates to which screen you want to display. If I swipe left on the homepage here, it will take me into my first page, which is my front room. And on here, we can see I've got a few different buttons. So as I mentioned, there's four different pages and with each page, you can have 8 buttons. The design that you'll see for each button is generated automatically based on whatever entity is set. So we can see here I've got a switch one for ones that are switches, I've got a light for one that's a light, and then the fourth button at the top in the corner here, my room clean button, that's a script that tells my robot to clean the front room. The switch acts as you'd expect. When you click it, the tile turns on so that you know that it's on, and when you click it again, it will turn off so you know that it's off. With the light button, you can click it to quickly turn the light on, but if you press and hold on it, it will take you into the light settings page, and on here you can customize the brightness level, you can use a color wheel to modify the color, and you can also use a temperature color slider to slide up and down to decide on whatever temperature you want the light to be on. If I carry on swiping through my screens, you'll see that on my third page here, which is my office page, I've got some other entities that we didn't have before. So on this one, I've got some cover entities for my window blinds and door blinds. Again, just like with the light, if we press and hold on these, it will take us into our cover settings. Inside your cover settings, you're able to set the position or the height that you want your blinds or curtains to be open to. And there's also a handy button for open, close and stop if you want to make use of those quick actions. As well as the features that I just mentioned, there's also a thermostat. So if you're making use of any kind of heating or climate controls, then you can control these using the thermostat page. And this will allow you to do things like adjust your heating level, you can turn the heating on and off, you can turn your hot water on and off, and other things that you'd expect to be able to do with a thermostat card. And I'm only just scratching the surface with this project. There's still lots of other cool features and things that you can do with it. For example, you can make use of a couple of different service calls. One of them allows you to play the RTTTL soundtracks on your device. So if you've got one of those 80s theme tunes that you want to hear, then you can do that. You can also display notifications on the device. So you can send some text and it will appear on the device as a little notification banner, and you can just open and close that as you wish. Another really cool addition is the fact that you can set confirmations per button. So this is going to stop those annoying accidental clicks. So when you press a button, it will also ask you, are you sure that you want to do this? And then you can either press yes or no to confirm or deny it. And there we go, guys. That's been a quick overview of the NSPanel Home Assistant Blueprint. Maybe they should work on that title so it just flows off of your tongue a little bit better. But that's been an overview of the project. And if you have enjoyed it and you want to check it out, again, there's links to it in the description below. And there's also a link to the video that I've done that will show you how to do all of that stuff if you don't if you'd rather watch a video rather than read about it. If you have enjoyed this video and you want to see more content from me, then don't forget to drop me a like. And if you're not already, hit the subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. And as always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons, and if you're interested in helping support my channel, which in turn allows me to create content like this, then you'll find a link to my Patreon in the description below. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers. Now, you're limited to just using the blueprint temp. The blueprint? The what? You're limited to just using the You're limited to just using the blueprint. I can't even say the word. The blueprint. Let's start again.